water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But this is what I want to concentrate on, verse 14. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up unto everlasting life.
Yes.
Can I tell you, you've got an eternal well of God. We used to sing this song, I've got a river of life flowing out of me. They used to sing, spring up a well within my soul.
Yes.
Spring up a well. Let me tell you something, the wells of God are being, untap one more time. This today, in New Birth, there's a place in the well. There's a place where you're being untapped for use. Because the master has come by and sat down on you. And see, when he began to address the eternal things in her, all of a sudden it became a matter of worship. Because he began to talk to her. He said, listen, I'm going to call you out right where you are. Go call your husband. What should have been wasn't. She goes on to say that she's had 5 husbands.
Yes, yes, yes.
She's gone on to say that even the one that she's with now, Jesus said, listen.
Yes, that's right.
He ain't yours.
That's right. That's right.
See, the problem is we've been like the body of Christ. We've been like the Samaritan woman. We don't know who we belong to.
Come on. Come on. That's
and we've
good.
Been playing around with everything and
that's
everyone.
Good. Yeah. That's good.
And the problem is our well always belonged to the master.
Yes, yes.
To the one that sat down and was willing to pour back in where he wanted to draw out from.
Yes, yes.
He said, I'll give you a well of living water.
Yes.
I want you ushers, I want my usher right now to come.
Thank you, Jesus.
And move this out of the way.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
I don't have a lot of important things.
Thank you, Father.
But see, here's the whole thing. I don't even